It's the middle of the morning rush hour at Crook Street, and the 8:35 CLC local passenger to Wigan Central is about to depart. Despite it being a busy time for passenger trains, there are still goods trains to dispatch, the 855 to Plodder Lane being the next one, and its engine comes off shed to join the water column queue on the shed departure road. Next to go off shed is the coal tank for the next Manchester Exchange passenger. In the yard, the little Ramsbottom 040 saddle tank is preparing the Plodder Lane train, consisting today of mostly full wagons from the morning's Deansgate trips. shunting continues as the 8:47 Manchester arrives into platform 4. Just before 8:55, with the train assembled, the bobby sets the road for the goods train. And on time, the 8:55 stopping goods to Podder Lane gets underway. As a stopping train, its next stop will be Lever Street, less than a mile away. This is now just a coal yard, although it used to house an oil department, now situated adjacent to the mission sidings. From there, it will go to Podder Lane, where it will terminate. Before the days of large concentrated marshalling yards, this was effectively just one of many outer holding yards for the Manchester area, and the train's wagons may well be remarshalled and attached to other trains for onward distribution to the multitude of yards in Manchester, or indeed further afield. It's a busy time for the shed turner too, with the Super D being sent out for the Dalham Lane through goods, this yard being an important connection with the main line at Warrington. The shed turner was an important job too. He was in charge of choreographing the movements of engines in and around the shed yard, effectively a head shunter. The shunter returns to the yard, just as the Ramsbottom tank has made its way to the shed to work the bank. At 9:03, it's time for the daily Heaton Mersey goods, hauled as usual by a Great Central pom-pom. This heavy Robinson-designed 060 goods engine acquired its unusual nickname due to the staff likening its strong exhaust beat to the pom-pom guns used in the Boer War. The shunter is quick off the mark to pull the CLC train into the yard. Just before 9:15, and the next Kenyon Junction motor train gets the road. Now the roads are clear, the coal tank is released to join its train, and the Super D moves along the queue. Soon after, the 9:20 down motor train from Kenyon Junction arrives. Three minutes later, and the Manchester local is ready to depart. Shunting continues as the passenger tank makes its way to the shed. Meanwhile, on Platform 1, George V Class Ptarmigan has been warmed up and gets the road ready to rush the 9:40 Express to Liverpool Lime Street.